The Padres, the Chargers, and Super Bowl 22. Also home of the SeaWorld Holiday Bowl, where we've seen some fantastic finishes. Let's look back and take a look.
3 seconds left, third and 10 at the SMU 41-yard line. McMahon all the way back in his own 46, throwing for the end zone. Receivers are there, defenders are there. It is in the end zone. Who has the ball?
BYU
touchdown!
21 seconds, first down, ball at the 15-yard line.
Again, in 1987, the black and gold of Iowa is back. Hayden Fry's Hawkeyes have racked up a 9-3 record, largely due to the play of quarterback Chuck Hartlieb, a man with a comeback style all his own.
Hartlieb with a ball and one setback and three flankers. Here's Hartlieb going out. He looks, he throws, it is complete, and it's an Iowa touchdown!
Out of the Wild West comes Iowa's opponent, the Wyoming Cowboys, where first-year coach Paul Roach rolled up 10 wins and a WAC championship. Cowboy fortunes riding on the quick draw of record-setting quarterback Craig Burnett, a gunslinger who likes to fire from long range. His ability to do that determines whether or not the Cowboys can shoot down the Hawkeyes. It's a sellout crowd. They couldn't print the tickets fast enough. Jack Murphy Stadium, the home of the Super Bowl. And as they increase the seating for the Super Bowl, they have sold more Holiday Bowl seats. Houghton spots the ball at the 35-yard line. A long delay for James Loving and Steve Vanna. And some emotion and perhaps some jangled nerves. But as soon as the helmets start to crack and the ball's in the air, the nerves and the butterflies give way. We're underway in San Diego, the 10th annual SeaWorld Holiday Bowl. End over end, not very deep at the 18-yard line. Steve Vanna cracks it around the left side, up around the 30-yard line. And that's where the Cowboys of Wyoming will start first and 10. Let's meet the Cowboys.
Craig Burnett, only 17 games as a Wyoming quarterback. He's thrown for over 4,000 yards, folks. He is a good one. Gerald Abraham, the leading rusher in the history of the program. Benny, you just saw, and he's a tough one. Hoffman is the leading receiver. Loving and Sergeant, great athletes on this team. Hoffman, not the leading receiver, but a good one at tight end. The tackles may be a problem. Iowa will go after them today. The best lineman, probably the center, Grant Salisbury. He makes the signal calls on the offensive line.
Loving comes in motion near side. Benna Abraham are the running backs. A little delay, nothing doing for Gerald Abraham, the senior out of Denver, and Myron Kepi, the senior out of Durant, Iowa. As you look at the Iowa defensive interior line, made the tackle.
Kepi, 77, made that tackle. Haight is the big guy, all Big Ten. Very tough. Wyoming will have to keep him out, no question about it. Burke is a starter. Ridley is filling in for Joe Mott, who has been suspended. We'll talk about him. The inside backers, Puck, major reconstructive surgery in the offseason on the shoulder. He's back, and he's a good one. These two guys at corner are very young. The safeties, Burke is the better of the two. Hess playing his first game.
Motion by Gibson out wide to the left side. Straight drop, Burnett, flare pass. Incomplete, deflected at the 33-yard line. Intended for Eric Loftus out of Portland, Oregon, and Kerry Burt, the senior out of Waterloo, Iowa, back in the coverage.
Two players on the Iowa defense, Jim. Joe Mott, the outside linebacker, a junior, and Dwight Sistrunk, two starters, were suspended by Hayden Fry prior to this game. He has not divulged the reason for the suspension, only to say that he has rules and he expects them to be followed. Both of those players are not here, and their backups have taken their spot.
Third and 11. First down for Wyoming at the 45. Scott Joseph breaks it almost to midfield. The senior out of Oakland, California, transfer from Shabo Junior College. 5'10", 185 pounds. First down, a 17-yard pickup.
Scott Joseph's going to run an intermediate route here. The key to this thing is Burt's going to miss the tackle. He's wide open. You see the strength of Burnett's arm. Now, not many people see Wyoming over the course of the year. That was Burt who couldn't get his hands on him. These receivers are very quick, and although they're small, they are strong. And Wyoming averages almost 500 yards a game, and it's no accident on offense.
Hoffman and Kilpatrick, Kevin, double tight end. Abraham moving back to the right. Burnett flares it out. Incomplete, misfires. Two Cowboys in the vicinity. Kilpatrick, the junior tight end, number 16 out of Sheridan, Wyoming, the intended receiver.
The thing that Wyoming does early in the game, they'll use a lot of formations and they'll make Iowa adjust. And when they find the plays that work, they'll go back to those plays continually. But early in the game, Coach Roach says, they do throw away some plays. They waste some downs to see how Iowa will defend them. And that's what you'll see here in the first quarter.
The Cowboys passing offense, very potent. Second and 10. The three-step drop by Burnett. Lots of time. The middle's wide open. First down, Wyoming at the 27-yard line. James Loving on a curling pattern. The senior out of Chicago, Anthony Wright, and Jay Hess back on the coverage.
This is not a great pass. The key is the time. Here's Dave Haight. Center Salisbury doing a great job on him. When he turns, he finds another lineman there. Plenty of time for Burnett. Now, this is kind of a dying duck type of pass, but Loving standing there, able to make the catch right in front of the zone. Wyoming offense.
Loving averages over 15 yards a catch. That one for 23 in the first down. Spotted at the 27 of the Hawkeyes. Cowboys on the move. Little delay. Abraham tries to go behind Salisbury and Fidji. Nothing doing as the Hawkeyes defense collapses. J.J. Puck, the first to arrive. The 6'3", 212-pound senior out of Cedar Rapids.
Wyoming last year under Dennis Erickson had a great passing attack. The problem was they did not run the ball very well. They couldn't get short yardage. That has changed with Coach Roach this year. He put in a running attack. Abraham over 1,200 yards. You know they're able to run, but they still have a little bit of problem with power football down towards the end zone.
On second and 9, play action fake. A little loop, incomplete. Burnett misfired. Again, Kilpatrick, the intended receiver. A little timing problem between the tight end and the quarterback.
Remember, Coach Roach told us also yesterday about Burnett. Sometimes he comes out and his timing is off. Wyoming sometimes is a slow-starting team. They've come back 6 times to win this year from way behind. Scored 29 points in the third quarter to beat BYU 29-27. He does get better as the game goes on, but he has his problems early.
Craig is 2 for 5, 43 yards, 2 big first downs, 3rd and 9. Key call early for the Cowboys. No one back, 5 receivers are out. Post drop at the goal line by Bill Hoffman out of Carson City, Nevada. Jay Hess on the coverage, but that was a catchable ball, should have been 6.
This is a pattern where they put everybody out, even the running back. Bottom of your screen is the running back. They're spreading the defense. Hoffman just inside. See, he's the second receiver inside, number 84. That ball just a little bit long. Hoffman dropping it when he's hit. We'll see that again. Iowa did not defend it well enough. The safety didn't get over in time.
A 43-yard try for Greg Worker. He's 4 for 10 from this distance. On its way, it is good. So the Cowboys take the opening kickoff. They use 3.5 on the clock, and they put 3 big points up on the board against the favored Hawkeyes. So the emotion of the Wyoming Cowboys as they strike first. Another look as Worker kicks it through from 43. Cowboys lead by a field goal.
No enemy has ever withstood our might. I need a weapon.
Rated M for mature.
Decide your destiny. A life of virtue or villainy is up to you. Fable, for every choice, a consequence. Rated mature.
A murder only he can solve. An enemy only he can defeat.
Hell no.
Come on! Did you just shoot at me with your eyes closed?
It worked, didn't it?
Will Smith, iRobot, tomorrow.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light.
So this holiday season, put out the good stuff. Planters.
How does the bottle work again?
Well, I fill it with authentic Guinness draft.
Yes.
So we can walk outside.
Yes.
Go down to the glen.
Yes.
And drink it.
Drink beer at a picnic. Brilliant. What will you think of next?
You know the way you call your mum?
Yes.
Well, I've created a device that lets you talk to her.
Brilliant.
Brilliant.
Brilliant. Guinness draft straight from the bottle. Enjoy it everywhere.
Brilliant.
Every Wednesday night, ESPN Classic gets your Irish up.
We're going to get them on a run. We're going to go, 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 go.
Every Wednesday night, ESPN Classic has a golden dome.
Here we go. Goodbye.
Every Wednesday night, there's only one place to find the Fighting Irish.
Touchdown, Notre Dame.
With the dominant players, the legendary games, and the inside stories, you'll have a better seat than the band. Classic Notre Dame, 9 p.m. Eastern, 8 Central, Wednesdays on ESPN Classic.
The sights of the SeaWorld Holiday Bowl. The Cowboys strike first after that 43-yard field goal by the senior out of Clayton, Michigan, Greg Worker. There he is. He'll kick it off from the 35 and back deep. Quinn Early, number one, the senior out of Great Neck, New York. And Tony Stewart, who averages almost 23 yards on the kickoff returns for the Hawkeyes. That's Quinn Early. End over end. Tony Stewart at the 11. Blockers to the 30. And dives to the 32. So the Hawkeyes of Iowa trailing 3-0, led out by Chuck Hartley.
They didn't even know this guy would be a starter early in the year. He's all Big Ten, threw for 300 yards 5 times this year. He's a great one. He's got another year. Harmon, an all-purpose back. He's a receiver and a runner. Over 600 yards on the ground. Very good. Marv Cook leads a contingent of 3 tight ends that are maybe the best in the nation. Quinn Early, big play receiver. The tackles, they move some people around, but they're studs. Big Ten people. Best lineman is the center, Bill Anderson. Good pass protector. Calls the signals on the offensive line.
Early wide to the right. Watkins wide to the left out of the I pro set. The tailback and nothing doing as the Cowboys converge. Harmon is stacked up. Let's meet the Cowboy defense.
These guys are wild and crazy. Pat Raybould and Napton, the strength on that defensive line. They pay 4 down. These guys will move around all night. The defensive ends are a little bit small, but pretty good pass rushers. They don't play so well against the run. You can expect them to be tested. Galen Thaxton, the leading tackler in the history of the Wyoming program. We'll get to the secondary after this play.
Underneath at the 30-yard line, David Hudson. Hudson cracks it up near the 40-yard line. Still shy by 3 yards of first down yardage. Mike Schenbeck, number 55, the junior out of Aurora, Colorado, on the stop. The secondary now for the Cowboys.
And these guys will get tested all day. Reggie Berry and Steve McMillan. Berry is a cover guy, an excellent cover guy. You go to the safeties, old Slick Harris, who's maybe not such a great tackler. They say he's a little undependable. He's a free safety. That's why he's back there. Mike Hill, very tough, a linebacker type. And they'll switch up their coverages against that great Iowa passing attack all day.
Penalty against the Iowa Hawkeyes. Let's check
Haley
it out.
Haley on the offense. 10 yards from the previous spot. Still second down.
So it is second down now and 23 yards to go instead of 3rd and 3 for the Hawkeyes. And Kevin, let's go back to what we talked about at the top of the telecast. The emotion certainly very definitely in the Cowboys' favor early.
Wyoming wants to win this game very, very badly for the WAC conference and themselves, and Iowa does too, but maybe emotionally Wyoming a little more.
Hudson, the only back. Hartley looks. Almost intercepted at the 15-yard line. Number 89, or number 99, David Adine, the junior out of Cheyenne, had it in his hands but was so surprised, Kevin, it got there so quickly he didn't have time to react.
Well, Hartley goes all the way back, Jimmy, and he never steps up into the pocket. See him sitting deep? The Wyoming rush gets to him, and you're right. Right there, that ball had a chance to be picked off by Adine.
3rd and 23. Raybould with a lot of pressure on Hartley. The senior quarterback out of Woodstock, Illinois, looks over that Cowboy defense. Over the middle, a curl in at the 39-yard line. Caught, but he's still 4 yards shy of first down yardage. Mike Flagg, the senior out of Cedar Falls, Iowa. Big defensive series early on. Cowboys score, lead 3-0. The defense A little bit undersized, Kevin. They stuffed Iowa, and that's a good motion.
Yeah,
good
it helps momentum. Them. They got a break, Jimmy. They got a break on that first completion, and then the penalty really helped them. Iowa can't get away with that in this game.
Anthony Sargent back deep. Lets it hit at the 25. And will be blown dead at the 24-yard line. Penalty flag. No, it's no flag. It might have been kicked by one of the Cowboys. I believe, Kevin, that one of the Wyoming players kicked the ball and it was covered.
Well, the ball was kicked by a Wyoming player. It might have been after the whistle. We'll see what they spotted.
.37 left to go in the first quarter. Wyoming took the opening kickoff and marched down a 43-yard field goal, the difference early.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light.
So this holiday season, put out the good stuff. Planters.
ESPN's double coverage weekend starts Saturday at 8:30 with an NFC showdown. And Sunday night, two AFC powerhouses collide. It's a double coverage weekend. Panthers-Falcons, Saturday night at 8:30. Ravens-Colts, Sunday night at 8:30 on ESPN.
On the next 60 Minutes on Classic.
He's a king just like Elvis. He's a legend.
Back in 1988, Harry Reasoner sat down with racing legend Richard Petty when he was still king of NASCAR.
I'm in a unique position because I've been doing this 30 years.
Wait till you hear just how far he went to win.
When I had my neck broke, I shouldn't have been driving. I've driven with broke ribs. I've driven with broke feet.
An audience with a king. 60 Minutes on Classic, 8 p.m. Tuesday on ESPN Classic.
Is your financial company giving you the security you need? We're in. Hey, join the evolution. Okay, we're out. Because it's your future.
We are the men and women of the United States Army Reserve. We are regular people who share our time serving our country and our communities. Our training makes us stronger as soldiers and as citizens who stand ready.
To find out how you can serve your country in the Army Reserve, call 1-888-624-ARMY for this free DVD and get a free sports watch. Stand ready in the Army Reserve.
Along with Charlene Hawks, Kevin Kiley, I'm Jim Kelly. Welcome back to the 10th SeaWorld Holiday Bowl. The Cowboys, a four-point underdog to the Hawkeyes of Iowa, leading 3-0, 8:21 to go in the first quarter. Spotted just outside the 45-yard line of Iowa. You look at Craig Burnett, the senior quarterback out of California, 6'1", 175 pounds, and what he's done in his career at Wyoming. Cowboys like to get off the bus throwing the football. We talk about five wideouts and nobody in the backfield to block. He's 2 for 8, 43 yards, and two big first downs that led to that go-ahead field goal. Motion by Loving. Play action fake. Loving wide open. Did he stay in bounds? He did. At the 37-yard line. He'll be about 3 yards shy of first down yardage. Sean Ridley, the junior out of Omaha, beaten for Iowa.
Hawkeyes' philosophy was going to be we're going to go with coverage and not pressure on the passer. They're not getting the pressure, but the coverage is not close enough against these guys. Both wide receivers for Wyoming, Loving and Anthony Sargent, you see Loving there, are junior college transfers, as is Craig Burnett, as is the tight end Hoffman. These guys are little, not major college material out of high school, but great athletes.
On second and three, a delay around the left side, blocking by Weir as Gerald Abraham is stacked up. Third and short coming up for the Cowboys. Well, there were 26 head coaches in Division I that changed locations as the 1987 season began, and these five all have their teams in bowl games. The Cowboys, Paul Roach, the Tigers, Mike Archer, the Trojans, Larry Smith, and Bill Curry, of course, for the Crimson Tide of Alabama, and Dave McWilliams in his rookie season at Texas. Great job by those five gentlemen. And there is Paul Roach, 60 years young. Talked it over with his wife. They said, why not? So he's wearing two hats. He's the athletic director and the head football coach. First time that's ever happened at Wyoming. Abraham motions wide left. Burnett fires, got his man at the 33, turns it up to the 25, and Anthony Sargent dives out of bounds for a Wyoming first down.
Well, they got the coverage they want. They got Ridley, the backup linebacker, who's starting with Mott out. Burnett, the accuracy here. Look at this. This is good coverage by Ridley. Sargent makes a nice catch. Ridley almost had his hand on that ball. Great pass by Burnett in execution. And he's heating up, maybe a little happy. He knows he hasn't been throwing well.
Spotted at the 22 of the Hawkeyes. Lone running back, Steve Benna, motions to the white. All kinds of time. End zone! No, he just sailed out of bounds. Sargent, nicknamed Sarge, out of Los Angeles. A breakaway threat. Outstanding speed. Dangerous and fearless over the middle. Missed the spring with a shoulder injury. A junior college transfer.
Look at this catch.
Look at the extension.
He hit the ground. Never had possession. That's some great athletic ability for a guy. 5'8". 170 pounds, one of those little wide receivers.
Crowd reacted to the replay on the screen at Jack Murphy Stadium. On second and 10 from the 22. Abraham dances down to the 20 in the grasp of J.J. Puck. Third and 9 coming up now for the Cowboys. They're in field goal range. Worker already with a 43-yard kick.
They're not going to win this game 3 points at a time, Jim. Not against Iowa. Iowa's a very fine football team.
But they can peck away and peck away and keep the ball from the Hawkeyes. Batted down at the 3-yard line by Anthony Wright, the junior out of Dallas, Texas. He's only 5'10", 175 pounds, but he got up there and batted the ball away and saved six. Hoffman, the intended receiver.
Hey, you noticed the last time they were down here, they went to the tight end, and again they go to the tight end. He dropped the first one. This one's thrown into coverage. Wright coming back, helping his own safety. Ball could have been intercepted.
This will be a 37-yard try for a Worker, who's already connected, the senior out of Clayton, Michigan, from 43 yards. John Wiggins puts it down on its way, and it is good. From 43 and 37 yards, the Cowboys have a 6-0 lead over the Iowa Hawkeyes. Well, if you're a Cowboy rooter, Kevin Conley, 6:37 to go, you lead the favorite Hawkeyes by 6. A lot to cheer about.
I would not really be concerned with the offense. They knew they'd be good offensively. If I was cheering, I'd be cheering for the fact that their defense has played well to this point. Iowa is very explosive, and I expect them to score a lot of points in this game still against the Wyoming defense when they figure out what it is Wyoming is doing.
And, of course, the head coach at Iowa, Hayden Fry, took over a program that had, well, they'd only been to 2 bowls in 90 years, as you see on that graphic. But since Hayden Fry took over back in 79, 7 straight bowl bids in the last 9 years. He is the winningest coach with 70 victories at Iowa University. You know, they had lost 19 straight seasons under 4 different coaches. He came in, Kevin, and discipline was really the rule. He began by having the fellows be required to go to class, tuck the shirt in. Some of the rules might have seemed silly at the time, but he said any discipline in the football program starts in the classroom and as a young man. And you have to have the individual pride before you can be a football player.
That's the work ethic, Jim. It carries over right onto the football field. People who think they can let players run free most of the week and then come to practice and get anything accomplished, they can't do it.
Worker, who has field goals from 37 and 43. Short kickoff for the 12. Tony Stewart down at the 26-yard line. Down on the sidelines are Charlene Hawks.
In talking with the offensive and defensive coordinators prior to the game, I think we all got the distinct impression that it's very different preparing for a bowl game as opposed to a regular season. They said that usually they only spend about 4 days watching 3 to 4 films. Well, now they had almost a month. They said it was a little too tempting not to watch all 11 or 12 films. But after they did, it kind of left them in a bind, they said, a little bit too confused, not knowing what to do. Could there be such a thing as preparing too much for a bowl game?
That's so Charlene, good point. They point out that the bowl game is supposed to be a reward. 6:32 left to go. Hawkeyes trail by six, bat pedaling. Hartley looks, unloads. Penalty flag is down, and so is number 20, David Hudson. Fights back maybe to the original line of scrimmage. Mike Schenbeck got there first for the Cowboys. Number 55, the junior out of Aurora, Colorado.
I think that's a very good point that she made. After we get this hold, he's going to be holding on Iowa, another major penalty. That's not going to help. But what she says is right, especially against a team like Wyoming. They do so many things. Now, Hayden is his assistants. They usually look at a couple of films, and the Big Ten really doesn't have a team like Wyoming. And then they look at 11 or 12, and this team virtually changed every single week. Paul Roach has a pro history. He coached with John Madden and Red Miller at Denver. And he knows a lot of things, and this team is very versatile. A lot of seniors they've learned, and they're very complex. To look at all 11 or 12 teams, you don't know what they're going to do, and that could be a problem that Iowa's having here in the first quarter.
Well, as you look at Paul Roach, of course, if you play in the Western Athletic Conference, you play to get into the Holiday Bowl. If you play in the Big Ten, you play for the Rose Bowl bid. Hayden Fry and the Hawkeyes mixed out, and he was a little worried about the motivational factor. Would his team be inspired enough? He admitted to us the other day at practice, we've not had good workouts. He said, I had to get on the boys a little bit. And flags again. Webster, number 73, might have jumped off sides for Iowa.
I got to believe a team like Iowa, they get hit in the nose a few times by the Wyoming team, and a contact will definitely motivate you if you're a football player, and getting behind will motivate you. So they may come out if they do a little flat, if that's the case, but they'll get
going. Ball, full start on the offense, still first down.
So successive five-yard penalties. And that's three penalties early on. Look at that. The Cowboys have been perfect in the penalty department. Hayden Fry getting on the troops a little bit now. Inside of 6 minutes when the ball is snapped. 6-0. Wyoming on top.
Well, Iowa's only had 63 penalties for 519 yards. That's less than 45 yards a game. And that's pretty good for a team. So this is really not the way they usually operate.
To the tailback. Kevin Harmon breaks it at the 20-yard line. Stiff arms to the 27, to the 28. And hammered out of bounds by Darrell Slick Harris. Harris came to the Pokes as a wishbone quarterback. Now he's a sophomore free safety. A pickup of 17.
Wyoming, watch the line from Wyoming. They're going all over the place. Stunting. They're all slanting. Actually, that's a slant to the right. And Harmon comes back to the left. And that was a good job here by the corner, holding up the block and letting the rest of the defense come and catch up. And the Wyoming has been good this year, although their defensive statistics aren't good. They've been good at taking things away, like the running game for a running team, the passing game for a passing team, making the big plays when they had to.
Second and eight. Line hold, good protection for Hartley, but he misfires at the 32, looking for Mike Flagg, the senior tight end, who is 6'6", 250, a big target out of Cedar Falls, Iowa.
And linebacker coverage from Schenbeck there. And again, it's going to take a while for Hartlieb to figure out some of these coverage. Wyoming runs a lot of coverage. That's not been Hartlieb's strength, Jim, is reading coverages and picking up blitzes. That's not his strength. His strength is his arm.
Hartlieb now one out of four in the passing department, 20 yards. He keeps two backs in, Hudson and Harmon. Watkins to the left, Early to the right. The audible by the senior quarterback out of Woodstock, Illinois. Batted down at the 20-yard line. That's an incompleted pass, not a fumble. And David A. Dean, the junior out of Cheyenne, 6'4", 255, got those huge redwood-like three arms up in the face of Chuck Hartley. Offensive line's going to have to make some adjustments.
Well, they're showing blitz. Wyoming walked up to the line of scrimmage, showed blitz. Hartlieb, I believe, went to an audible. And then when he came out, there was nothing there. Wyoming covering the wideouts. That's where he wanted to go, and he couldn't get the ball off.
Marv Cook having a busier night as a punter than he is as a tight end. Fair catch called for at the 37-yard line by Anthony Sargent. And again, good field position for the Cowboys of Wyoming. 5:18 to go. They lead 6-0 after that 44-yard kick. And as you look at that spectacular shot high over San Diego's Jack Murphy Stadium, the airship, the Goodyear Blimp, Columbia, based in Carson, California. The pilot is John Creighton. The home base is Hermosa Beach, California. There's our score. We've got 5:18 to go in the first quarter.
So what's this about old Guinness again?
I've discovered that Guinness Draft has only 125 calories.
Only 125 calories? Brilliant! What else have you been up to?
I've invented this little book. It's black. You put women's phone numbers in it.
A little black book? Brilliant!
Come here often.
You can also use it as a coaster.
A coaster? Brilliant!
Brilliant!
Guinness Draft has only 125 calories. Enjoy it responsibly.
Brilliant!
Spider-Man 2 on DVD, the must-see movie of the year, is now the must-own DVD for the holidays. A triumphant sequel. Ebert and Roper give it two thumbs way up. Web-packed with bonus features. It's the ultimate DVD for the ultimate Spidey fan. Spider-Man 2 on video and DVD.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light.
So this holiday season, put out the good stuff. Planters.
This holiday, discover the magic at Radio Shack. And during our big two-day sale, Tuesday and Wednesday only, get great deals on very entertaining gifts. Like this DVD player, just $34.99 after rebate. A 7-inch portable DVD player, only $129.99 after rebate. And a 15-inch Magnavox LCD TV, only $399.99 after rebates. Tuesday and Wednesday, right in your neighborhood.
Only at Radio Shack.
No enemy has ever withstood our might.
I need a weapon.
Rated M for mature.
Sometimes you have to hit rock bottom.
He's a loser.
Everybody wants a piece of me.
Before you catch your big break.
How can I lose?
Paul Newman stars in The Hustler.
Yeah.
Real classics. 8 Eastern Sunday. Only on ESPN Classic.
Burnett sets the Cowboys down, looks to the right, comes back to the left. A drag foot by Eric Loftus. Will they give him the reception? They say yes. Right in front of Hayden Fry and the Hawkeyes, who don't like that call. The senior out of Portland, Oregon, a six-footer with a great extra effort. His dad played at Montana State.
Straight zone, a nice throw by Burnett, and look at the catch. And the toe, and a good call by the official. Burnett heating up a little bit. He's getting a little more accurate.
Off the replay, some of the fans didn't agree. Eric's brother, Jeff, played at Montana, and his sister, Cindy, runs track at Oregon. They're an athletic family. You'd expect to catch one. Motion by Abraham on first and 10. Offensive front for the Cowboys holds. Pass is completed at the 47-yard line to Sargent and J.J. Puck on the cover.
One of the problems a linebacker has against a team like the guy like J.J. Puck, number 32, that's Brad 32, top of your screen, coming up and making that tackle. The problem he wants to play the run. He's a big, tough guy, 6'3", 212 pounds, plays the run very well. Against a passing team, you can be frustrated, dropping back all the time, not being able to get your hands on those guys. And when you do, you want to make an impression.
From the 47 of Iowa, power dive off the right side. The hole sealed off. Steve Benner went nowhere. The sophomore out of Omaha, Nebraska, the architect major. And Brad Quash, the sophomore out of Des Plaines, Illinois, made the hit.
Wyoming just picking away at him with the pass and the run. Not really having much success running the ball, but throwing the ball well enough and keeping the run in the game plan.
And time of possession, very important in the first quarter. Cowboys have very effectively kept the ball away from Iowa. Spotted at the 45 on third and 3. Abraham sprints out wide to the left, top of your screen now. First down for the Cowboys and more. He caught him at the 40, loose football. But they are saying that Hoffman's knee was down in the vicinity of the 32-yard line. Hawkeyes came up with a loose football, but Bill Hoffman was down. And Hoffman is down, the senior out of Carson City, Nevada.
Bill Hoffman, number 94, left of your screen. He's just leaving your screen. He and Burnett played junior college ball together. You wonder why he's the leading receiver, or one of them. It's a good throw. Let's see where he gets hurt. He's down the ball. I'm sure it looked like he had it when he hit the ground. Might be a rib injury. Looked like he got hit the side and lower left side.
So we'll take a timeout. 3:47 to go in the first quarter. Cowboys leads Iowa 6-0.
We're going to make accounts payable exciting again. That's what we need to do, people.
In the time it takes to clean out your desk, you could save hundreds on car insurance. GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
Woo! Yeah.
Cool!
Crazy, Chris. That's crazy. 8 essential vitamins and minerals, but it won't save you money on car insurance.
Okay.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
Why haven't you called GEICO?
Girl power activated. Let's go.
Yeah, I'll call you from the car.
Line the highs down. About 10 years ago.
Dial Laura. I didn't know.
Technology to go. Chevy Trailblazer. An American Revolution.
What are you holding now?
A six-pack.
A six-pack? Brilliant! What'd you do?
Well, I figured out how to carry six beers at the same time.
Carry six beers at the same time? Brilliant! Let's drink them.
You know, I've been thinking, it might not be the smartest idea to drink six beers at the same time.
Don't drink six beers at the same time? Brilliant!
Brilliant!
Drink Guinness Draught straight from the bottle and always enjoy it responsibly.
Brilliant!
Inside that microphone is something familiar. A battery. And while you might think all batteries are the same, consider this. When Bon Jovi puts on a show, the battery that powers their microphones is always a Duracell. So whether you've got 50,000 screaming fans or you're working a slightly smaller room, it just has to work. Duracell. Trusted everywhere.
Let's take a look at Bill Hoffman now. Watch number 94 on the left side of your screen, right there.
All right, he's fine here, Jim. And then he gets to run, and I think he, watch him expose, see the helmet? Right in the hip, pelvis area, or the lower rib. And that appears to be where the injury occurred. What the injury is, we don't know.
First and 10, Wyoming at the 32 of Iowa. Motion by Gerald Abraham, wide to the left. Backpedaling, Greg Burnett. Looks, fires, got his man at the 13-yard line. Tom Kilpatrick, how about that? Comes in cold off the bench, makes a key catch for a big first down.
He came in with only 11 catches for 76 yards. Now, that's not really a reflection of how well he receives the ball, but probably of the type of year that Hoffman is having. There is a flag down on this play, however, and Wyoming's going back.
They're going way back because the flag was thrown at the 38-yard line, deep in the backfield. Generally indicates holding.
Yeah, you shouldn't have to hold with a three-step drop, but evidently that's what they did on this play.
Pat Flood, our referee, so we'll get the call at the 3:23 mark of the first quarter.
Holding on the offense, 10 yards in the previous spot, still first down.
One of the things that Wyoming does is they take that short drop by the quarterback, a three-step drop, and the receivers get into the secondary quickly.
So it brings up first and 20, and it would have been first and goal. Spot it now, way back at the 38. Check it, at the 42-yard line. That was a 32-yard holding call against the Cowboys. Slot wide to the right. Football behind Weir and Salisbury, and the sophomore Steve Bennett cracks it right up the middle. Dave Haight, the nose guard, on the stop.
Jim,
Charlene, how about an injury update?
We just talked with Bill Lyons, the head trainer for Wyoming, and he said that Bill Hoffman's right upper arm is broken. He was, of course, holding very still as they wheeled him off. I'm sure a very disappointing accident for this young man.
So the number one wide receiver, and that's what he is. A tight end is actually a wide receiver the way the Cowboys deploy five wideouts. Out with a broken arm, Bill Hoffman. Iowa drives tonight, three possessions, three punts. And the Cowboys with this 6-0 lead. 2:28 to go, and Wyoming wants a timeout. So we'll take a timeout. 2:28 left to go in the first quarter. Second and 17, the ball at the 39-yard line. And Kevin, let's go back to that momentum factor. Wyoming has pushed Iowa's around pretty well.
Well, no question, the Cowboys have the momentum, and what they're looking for here, at the very least, is a field goal to put them up 9 points, and Iowa would need two scores to get the lead back.
Be sure and be with ESPN tomorrow night for college basketball SEC style. The Kentucky Wildcats, led by Rex Chapman, go down to Nashville, Tennessee, to take on the Commodores of Vanderbilt. Vandy extremely tough at home, just ask Dean Smith, whose Tar Heels were upset there earlier this month. Join Bob Rathman and Dick Vitale for all the action beginning at 8 o'clock Eastern time. More college hoops on ESPN. There goes the number one receiver for the Cowboys. Just 3 receptions short of Wyoming's all-time mark. Bill Hoffman, a senior out of Carson City, Nevada. Not the way a senior would like to close out your college career. Bowl game of reward, but looks like he's in pretty good spirits.
That's a tough cookie. That's a tough cookie for you, waving to the camera with a broken arm. He's been a great one for Wyoming all year, and a big loss in spite of that catch by Kirkpatrick right away. And he's a guy that really makes it go. He almost had that touchdown early in the game. It was just over his fingertips, and he seems to be okay.
And the coaches feel he's a legitimate pro prospect.
There's a lot of them on this Wyoming team and the Iowa team.
Second and 17 of the 39 of Iowa. Burnett, all kinds of time, unloads, deflected, and almost picked off. Scott Joseph, the intended receiver, the senior out of Oakland, California, that junior college transfer. And it brings up third and 17.
We asked the Wyoming defensive coaches, how would you defense this great offense that averages almost 500 yards a game, your own offense? They said they would blitz it. Iowa is not blitzing it. They're trying to cover, and their coverage, very frankly, their zone cover is getting beaten early in the game. We may see him go to a blitz here pretty quick.
3 wideouts, Sargent, Loving, and Loftus, all deployed wide to the right. Gibson motions to the left. Now the blitz. Burnett reads it. Caught at the 15 by the Sarge. Anthony Wright on the coverage. Boy, you couldn't lay the ball in any better.
There's no defense for this. They sent Ridley, among other people, number 90, and they get to Burnett. But look at Burnett. And look at the way these guys work together. Both these kids are junior college players. They've only been there for a year or two. Look at that catch and throw and execution by the Cowboys. And that's coaching, and that's drilling over and over again. Sergeant, J.C. player from California.
Great touch by Burnett, because Kepi had the arms up, and he just got it over the outstretched arm.
And
nice touch.
Threw it into the middle of his own, too.
From the 15, first and 10, Cowboys, they lead 6-0. Play action fake. Freezes the linebackers. Burnett goes for 6. Touchdown, Wyoming. James Loving. I'll be curious to see this on the replay to see if there wasn't a little pushing off.
Well, Hank, I agree with you, Jim. Hanks, there was something going on over there with Loving and Hanks, and there was no flag at all. Ball was thrown. When Burnett threw that ball, Loving was covered. That was either a bad throw or he had absolute confidence that he could make that catch in traffic.
Loving's second touchdown catch of the year. Last year, Loving had a school record 54 catches and 6 touchdowns. And the Cowboys will go for a 2-point conversion. This, a chance to put them up 14-0. Wideout. Burnett backpedals, looks over the middle, covered, comes back to the right, incomplete. 12-0 Wyoming, looking for Loving, who had the touchdown catch. Now let's see if there was any offensive pass interference. Watch 83 for Wyoming
and 45 for Iowa. Again, lots of time. Now the offensive line doing a remarkable job here. No pressure from the Hawkeyes. Now this ball is thrown into the corner. Loving, see the push there? Now it was either a push by Loving, we got into it late there, or a push by Hanks. The catch made by Loving, and it's a touchdown.
That's number 21 for Craig Burnett on the season, and the second, as we said, for James Loving, number 83. 5'9", 180 pounds, out of Chicago, Illinois. Loving, 3 catches, 46 yards, 1 touchdown on the night. And the Cowboys of Wyoming, a 4-point underdog to the Big Ten Hawkeyes of Iowa. But Wyoming leads 12-0 with 1:48 left in the first quarter. Surprised?
Yes, I'm so. You know what I'm surprised at? I'm not surprised that they're scoring. I'm surprised that Iowa is not getting pressure. the Wyoming line playing exceptionally well, and the Hawkeyes not really forcing the action on the defensive line.
Worker with field goals of 43 and 37 yards will kick it deep to Peter Marciano. Yep, the nephew of the famed heavyweight boxing champ Rocky Marciano. Tony Stewart, number 21, is also back there. And this is Quinn Early with some great speed. Needs some blockers, cracks it up across the 25 to the 26-yard line. Well, we talked about Craig Burnett's 21st touchdown toss. There's the drive. 8 plays, 63 yards, 3.5 minutes. And Loving with a great grab in the left corner of the end zone, a 15-yard scoring strike. Cowboys lead 12-0. And they've kept the ball away from Iowa very effectively. Three possessions, three punts for the Hawkeyes. And I think what happens sometimes, Kevin, when the little guy starts beating up on the big guy gets a little frustrated and he starts making mistakes. And we've seen the Hawkeyes make some penalties.
Or he gets mad.
And gets rough and tough and gets angry. Quickly. Off left tackle. Alexander and Schmidt blocking for David Hudson up near the 31-yard line. Galen Thaxton, the senior middle linebacker, 6'1", 230 out of Denver, Colorado, stopping that man, David Hudson.
Well, if I'm Iowa, I'm going right at him now. They rush for 141 plus a game, and they pass for almost 300 yards a game. I think they need to establish the running game, and I'll just tighten down the chin strap and go right at the Cowboys. Let them know this is the Big Ten, this is how we play. Use that size of it.
Hudson, the fullback, he's got the ball. Blocking by Anderson and Divis up front. Here come the Cowboys. Scott Hanser, the first to arrive, the senior out of Billings, Montana.
Number 90, Galen Thaxton, is a leading tackler in Wyoming history. He's had an injury to the knee, problem getting off blocks. No problem here. He just sits, he reads, he steps in the hole. And here's number 90. Hi, I'm number 90, introducing himself to number 20 and making the play. Somebody's got to come out and get him, either a center or a guard. Nobody touched him on that play.
You've played linebacker, and when you've got gang tackling like that, everybody is in the game emotionally. You know, the adrenaline's going for everybody.
Well, you know, you get that because people are moving, Jim. Everybody on this defense moves at the snap of the ball, and they're running games, and a lot of guys get loose, so you do get gang tackling.
They'll be coming now on third and five. Hartley got his man, Quinn Early, and that's a Hawkeye first down. An 11-yard pickup. Coleman back there on the coverage.
He's been quiet, Quinn Early's first team all Big Ten. 61 catches for over 900 yards. It's man coverage. They come with the blitz. Wyoming does. Hartley does a great job. So does Early. Breaking it off early, I guess. Right, because it's a blitz. Hartley hit him with a good pass. That's probably the best offensive play Iowa has run since very early in the game.
Early only needs four catches to become the Hawkeyes' single-season all-time pass catcher.
Center snapped the ball there, Jim. The rest of the line, the center missed the count.
But no flag. Time expiring in first quarter. And it's been all Wyoming. The Hawkeyes came in a 4-point favorite. Wyoming didn't read the papers. They lead 12-0 on one touchdown and two field goals.
No enemy has ever withstood our might.
I need a weapon.
Rated M for mature.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light.
So this holiday season, put out the good stuff. Planters.
On the next 60 Minutes on Classic.
He's a king just like Elvis. He's a legend.
Back in 1988, Harry Reasoner sat down with racing legend Richard Petty when he was still king of NASCAR.
I'm in a unique position because I've been doing this 30 years.
Wait till you hear just how far he went to win.
When I had my neck broke, I shouldn't have been driving. I've driven with broke ribs. I've driven with broke feet.
An audience with a king. 60 Minutes on Classic, 8 p.m. Tuesday on ESPN Classic.
Well, Jiffy Lube's been in business for a long time, and the philosophy has always been customer and people-oriented.
I expect them to treat the customer with respect and work on the car the way they would want their car to be worked on.
I want everyone to treat our female customers just like they would treat their own mothers.
At Jiffy Lube, we care about your car. We care about your time.
As the owner of my Jiffy Lube, I expect our customers to be treated as well as I would like to be treated.
Safe, professional, affordable. Have you been waiting for affordable LASIK? Now, Future Vision Laser Center has the answer for you. The ultimate LASIK experience. The ultimate LASIK experience starts at just $195 per eye, the lowest price in Illinois today. And it's only available at Future Vision Laser Center. Call 1-888-633-6333 now. Don't miss this once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Future Vision Laser Center. Safe, professional, affordable.
From the 20-yard line, good penetration. Sean Ridley sacked Burnett. Ridley, the junior out of Omaha, 25 tackles, 6 sacks on the season.
The physical advantage, Jim, for Iowa, we talked about it just a second ago, will really not show itself until late in this game. You know, playing at Laramie in the high altitude, generally Wyoming has a big advantage in the second half because of the altitude, and players get exhausted playing in Laramie. Here it's a little different. You're at sea level, and Iowa has that physical advantage, which should show up late in the game.
Burnett looks at 2nd and 17. Gerald Abraham motions top of your screen. 3-step drop, the fire completed at the 20-yard line. Little turn-in pattern, and that is Gordy Wood, number 95, the freshman tight end. Charlene Hawks, the Cowboys, as you know, are slow starters, but not tonight.
A very impressive and unexpected start for Wyoming. I think they're a little bit surprised themselves, but they are notorious for having slow starts. But Iowa is also known as a comeback team, and so we'll be seeing a lot from them, I'm sure, the next half.
Who are your friends down there? 9:49 left to go before halftime. Charlene Hawks, our sideline reporter tonight. Kevin Kiley up here in the booth. I'm Jim Kelly, and hope you're enjoying the 10th SeaWorld Holiday Bowl on ESPN. Third and 10. Spotted back at the original line of scrimmage. Good point. Burnett misfires. The receiver went underneath, and the ball was thrown on the outside, and great pressure by number 5, Mike Burke, the senior out of Davenport, Iowa. 6'5", 225, the business major, a career-high 9 tackles against Minnesota this year. Tom Kilpatrick, again, he's the backup tight end. He's also the punter. Marciano is back deep. Averages about 3.5-4 yards on punt returns. Would like to get it into Wyoming territory and set up the offense here in good field position. Here come the Hawkeyes, and they block it. This will be 6. Jay Hess started his career as a quarterback. He knew what to do with it when he found it. Your eye on number 48, Tyrone Berry, the senior out of Mount Vernon, New York. 6'2", 228. I believe it was Berry, Kevin, that came crashing through to block it. We'll get the extra point and the jubilation over on the Hawkeye sideline. Rob Hovland out of the hold of Chuck Hartley, the quarterback. And it's a 5-point Wyoming advantage as that punt by Kilpatrick was blocked. See, it was number 48. For the Hawkeyes.
Well, this was a tight punt formation. Where they come from is right in this area. Wyoming in a tight punt formation, nobody wide, trying to protect their punter. They don't get it done. You can see him coming right up the center. Now the up back is the guy that has to make that play, but because the wide guy took him away, everybody got up the center and made the plays a bad snap too. He drops the ball on the ground. That may have been the difference right there. Good bounce for Iowa, and they're in, and that's a big, big play for the Hawkeyes, but they're a big play team, too. We talked about it. Lots of leaders. They know what they have to do.
Well, there's the former quarterback, Jay Hess. Carried it in after that block punt, 9:26. They're replaying it here, and some of the Iowa fans is the big Iowa banner. The black and yellow goes around Jack Murphy Stadium. Interesting what Hayden Fry did when he took over the program at Iowa. Again, we go back to the fact that they had 19 straight losing seasons under 4 coaches. He liked the black and yellow. He called up the Pittsburgh Steelers, who were in the midst of winning their 4 Super Bowls then, and said, tell me about your uniforms. Tell me about the width on the uniforms of the yellow stripe. The The trainer said, I'll do better than that. So he sent Hayden Fry Terry Bradshaw's jersey. And the Iowa Hawkeyes molded those jerseys right after the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Everything but the helmet. We'll talk about that helmet later. As I said, two great helmets.
Loving, 83, is back deep along with Steve Bannon, number 22 for the Cowpokes. So from an emotional standpoint now, after being dominated early in the football game, interesting to see if this will fire up the Hawkeye defense a little bit. They're only one play out now from taking the lead.
The psychology of when you're playing on the field, I know when I was playing defense, if you got 6 or 7 points down, you really weren't worried. You always felt like, I can make a play and I can get back, I can win the game. But when you got two scores down, like Iowa was here just a few moments ago, it started to wear on you a little. So that's a big touchdown. It puts them within a play of the lead, and it really changes your psychology, your feeling about the game. And of course, the same is true of Wyoming, who had a two-score lead, and now they're down to a one-score lead if Iowa gets a touchdown.
Houtland from the center of the field. Three-step approach, not very deep. It's end over end, and at the 13, it's James Loving. Good speed. He's got some blockers. Tries to get outside and turn the corner, and he's bumped out of bounds at the 24-yard line. 9:19 to go. James Pipkins bumped him out of bounds. So here come the Cowboys again, leading by 5. They led 12-0 after the first quarter, and the only scoring in the second stanza belongs to Iowa.
I think they may be missing Hoffman. Their offense, later stages of that first quarter, early here in the second quarter, has not really been as powerful as it was early in the game. Iowa may be getting used to it, too, which is takes an adjustment to play against these guys.
Motion by Abraham, top of your screen on first and 10. Burnett batted, incomplete at the 28-yard line. Contact made, and Dave Haight batted that ball up in the air. You can see the emotion the Hawkeyes now playing with after that quick score.
That's some big plays there by Haight, and J.J. Puck behind him covering the receiver that Burnett wanted to go to. Haight, of course, all Big Ten, a player that just makes all the plays. He's just manhandling the defense, has enough presence of mind to get up there. Now that pass was intended for a short receiver, and Puck was right on him, could have been intercepted.
Safety valve, Abraham, good play, picked up 5 yards on his own after being apparently stopped at the 31-yard line. Kerry Burt on the stop out of Waterloo, Iowa, the senior, 6'1", 207. He started his career as a wingback, switched over to defense in 1985 for Hayden Fry.
He leads with 7 interceptions, Jim. And Iowa's defensive philosophy here is they feel they don't have great athletes, but they'll hit you. So what they're doing is they're getting back in their zone. So Wyoming will complete some passes. They're going to come after him, try and knock it loose.
Burnett, play action fake, unloads. Got his man at the 39-yard line. Up to the 45 and across the 45, approaching midfield, goes Gordy Wood, number 95. Again, Wood, 95, is in there because of the injury to Bill Hoffman.
Play action pass, number 32. Puck right here, I believe, or here. I really can't tell. I should have a bigger circle. Let me try that again.
Or binoculars.
Right there. Watch the play action on this play. He gets held by the play action, and then they go outside to Abraham. Had the wrong guy, 32. I'm sorry. He's the guy chasing him down. Right there. Play action, held number 32, and they go wide.
From the 49, Burnett all kinds of time, and it's deflected again. Dave Haight, the nose guard, number 64 out of Dyersville, Iowa, again came crashing through. Haight, if his name is familiar, his brother Mike, of course, Hawkeye fans know, played at Iowa and was a first round pick of the New York Jets back in 1986.
Do you like my circles, Jim?
I do. I feel like you're on Hollywood Squares.
You see how I make them so perfect? I'm able to draw those things.
I'll take Kevin Kiley to block. The draw to Gerald Abraham. In the grasp of J.J. Puck. Well, Kevin alluded to the Hawkeye helmet. and Charlene Hawks has found one.
Take a look at this ANF. It stands for America Needs Farmers. About 3 years ago, Coach Fry and his team decided they want to do something to alert Americans to the plight of farmers across the country, the Midwest in particular. So they came up with this, and Coach Fry said it was their way of saying that we think you guys are great and we want to help. It certainly has attracted a lot of attention.
Great hawk on there, too.
What happened to the hawk guy that was under the helmet?
Yeah, that's a great hawk. That's another story about they needed a meaner, better-looking hawk, and they got one. And as you can see, seven straight bowl games, it worked good.
Hayden said it's the Tiger Hawk.
Tiger.
One of the meanest one he could find. Third and two. Not this way. Breaks it. Great individual effort by Steve Benna. The Hawkeyes had him stopped. Benna just kind of delayed at the 45-yard line and watched a couple of those Tiger helmets go by him.
He averages 5.3 yards a carry. Now, they say he's not quick, but he's fast, and he's running sideways, and it makes a difference. He was able to get outside, but a very tough runner, and when you average 5.3, that's why Guy got away from the University of Nebraska, living right in Omaha, out there with the Cowboys.
All-state MVP at Ralston High School in Omaha. From the 35. A quick slant in at the 24-yard line is complete. And the collision made is Anthony Sargent. Boy, you talk about concentration. The coach has said he is fearless over the middle. We've seen about three great catches by the Sarge.
And a great throw there, too. You're right, Jim, but a great throw by Burnett. The strength of the arm is really what made that play. Sargent wasn't open. But Burnett drilled it right in there, and then he got drilled.
Speaking of Burnett, we'll have Larry Burnett at halftime.
Oh, no relation.
Craig Burnett batted down. Steve Thomas, the senior out of Denver, a 6'1", 270-pound right defensive tackle, transferred to Iowa from Nebraska. There he is. Got his hands up, his big lumberjack-like arms, and batted that ball down. Cowboy looking at second and 10 from the 24-yard line. Their 12-point lead sliced to just five. Loving and Joseph. Wide outs left and right. The drop. Incomplete left corner of the end zone for James Loving. He's got one touchdown catch in the night, but Merton Hanks with him stride for stride, the sophomore out of Dallas. And I guess when you talk about stride for stride, you mention that Mr. Hanks excels in the 110 high hurdles. Great speed. A little lanky.
How is someone a little lanky?
6'2", 170.
That's lanky.
Did you ever play corner?
Yeah, yeah. I was 6'2", 149 when I played corner.
You were a lot lanky.
Yeah, I was pretty lanky.
Third and 10 from the 24. Motion goes Gibson. Burnett looks over the middle, fires on the post, first and goal inside the five. Gordy Wood again, the freshman, and he had Anthony Wright, the junior out of Dallas, beaten badly on the play.
All right, the key to this thing is Burnett makes the quick decision right over the defense. Before the safety of the corner can get there, and it's another perfect throw. We talked about him early in the game, how he warms up. Starts off maybe a little bit off, but he warms up. He's warming up, folks.
First and goal from the 3-yard line. Wood in motion. And so is Gerald Abraham. Cowboys get six more. Ecstatic in the first half here at the SeaWorld Holiday Bowl. 18-7 and a chance to make it 19 for Greg Worker. He's been perfect from field goals of 37 and 43 yards. The extra point, the hold by Sean Wiggins, is perfect. Watch the Denver Prep High School Player of the Year out of East High School in Denver, Gerald Abraham.
Wyoming line does a nice job piling it up. Abraham, 6 foot, just 198 pounds, running tough, getting in there.
the 13th touchdown for the education major, and the Cowboys lead 19-7.
Hey,
no, hey.
Okay, here.
Here. Mm-mm.
All right,
my man.
Bye-bye.
Yeah. Everyone's talking double because of Domino's new Double Melt Pizza. Layer upon layer of flavor with a creamy blend of cheeses and herbs between two thin crusts. Buy your medium one-topping Double Melt Pizza for $9.99 and get any second medium pizza for just $5 more.
Hey, don't.
Get the door. It's Domino's new Double Melt Pizza.
Yeah, I'll call you from the car.
Land the highest count, about 10 years ago.
Dial Laura.
Technology to go. Chevy Trailblazer, an American revolution.
So what's this about our Guinness again?
I've discovered that Guinness Draft has only 125 calories.
Only 125 calories? Brilliant! What else have you been up to?
I've invented this little book. It's black. You put women's phone numbers in it.
A little black book? Brilliant!
Come here often.
You can also use it as a coaster.
A coaster? Brilliant!
Guinness Draft has only 125 calories. Enjoy it responsibly.
Brilliant!
This holiday, discover the magic at Radio Shack. And during our big two-day sale, Tuesday and Wednesday only, get great deals on very entertaining gifts. Like this DVD player, just $34.99 after rebate. A 7-inch portable DVD player, only $129.99 after rebate. And a 15-inch Magnavox LCD TV, only $399.99 after rebates. Tuesday and Wednesday, right in your neighborhood.
Only at Radio Shack.
Early in the third quarter, the Hawkeyes fumbled through the end zone, resulting in a touchback. We move ahead now to the start of the fourth quarter, where Wyoming leads Iowa 19-7 right here on ESPN Classic.
Well, if you're a history major, the team trailing at the start of the fourth quarter has lost 6 of the last 10 Holiday Bowls. Wyoming knows it, and Iowa knows it. 2nd and 9 from the end zone. Burnett fires. That will be a crucial Cowboy first down. Charlene Hawks, is that a former St. Louis Cardinal you have?
Oh, what?
Former St. Louis Cardinal.
Okay, in roaming down the sidelines, I ran into this gentleman, Mr. Conrad Dobler, of course, who needs no introduction, but formerly with the St. Louis Cardinals. And you've got to be proud of this team that has had an incredible showing that you played for how many moons ago?
Well, it's getting on 20 moons now ago, and you use that word gentleman lightly, don't you? I'll tell you what, they're doing a heck of a job. You can talk about the quarterback and the offensive lot, but I think the defense there at Wyoming, which they've been famous for years, is doing a tremendous job today.
Anthony Wright takes it in for the touchdown. His first interception on the year, and it puts 6, and it puts Iowa right back into the football game. From the 32-yard line, he stepped in front of the errant Craig Burnett pass, and that's 6 for Iowa.
Iowa sitting in a zone the entire game, waiting for Burnett to make a mistake. Wright is a great cover guy, but this is his zone. Look at him sitting back there. He finally overthrows one, which you don't want to do in a deep zone. And Wright knows what to do with it when he gets it. And now the defense and the special teams have put 13 points on the board for Iowa, and they've been shut out offensively.
Extra point try coming up. Rob Houtland out of the hold of Chuck Hartlib. They're perfect. 32 yards, and the defense and the specialty teams. Watch Anthony Wright. Here's Hartlib. Never sees Wright. Hanging back, playing zone. Loving. It's over his head. There's Wright with his first interception of the year. And the junior out of Dallas, Texas, takes it in for the touchdown. It's now a 5-point Wyoming lead.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light.
So this holiday season, put out the good stuff. Planters.
Ladies and gentlemen, Howard Hughes.
saw the future.
Let's build him a plane that flies above the weather, across the country, across the world.
If you do that, you could lose everything.
Well, I won't.
He lived the dream.
You like a little adventure.
Do your worst, Mr. Hughes.
I have heard some disquieting rumors about Mr. Hughes. I'd like to know everything there is to know.
My investigators have turned up a lot of dirt.
We are in a street fight, and I'm not going to lose. He owns Pan Am. He owns Comet. But he does not own the sky.
Beyond the wealth.
You want me to bribe senators?
I don't want them bribed, Jack. I want them bought.
Something drove him.
You have called me a liar and a thief.
Beyond the legend.
Federal warrant.
They are touching things.
Is the truth behind the man.
I'll get a doctor. No one sees him like this.
Sometimes I truly fear that I'm losing my mind.
A Martin Scorsese picture. Leonardo DiCaprio, Kate Blanchett, Kate Beckinsale, Alec Baldwin.
She'll go faster.
The Aviator, rated PG-13, in theaters everywhere Christmas Day.
No enemy has ever withstood our might.
I need a weapon.
Rated M for mature.
We talked about this bowl having a history of close finishes. We've got another one coming up. How about the Hawkeyes, though, offensively? The offense has not been able to crack into the end zone. It certainly speaks well for the defensive job and the scouting that they've done for Wyoming.
I thought right at the end of that last drive, especially.
James Loving, number 83. As it hit at the 17, better cover it, picks it up, 25, 30, 35, stays on his feet, still keeps the knees turning to the 38-yard line.
Last play, Anthony Wright right here. They're playing a straight zone. He's going to go back to here and sit and wait for Burnett to make a mistake. He's going to drop the ball right in there. That's where he's going. And down the other way. Hello, goodbye. Let's watch it. Right in that zone, just sitting. They try the hook. Burnett throws it long, and we're off to the races. That's just good zone defense, folks. They've been playing it all night, making it work.
Cowboys would like to get some confidence back after that last turnover. They'll keep it on the ground, work on the clock. Trap blocking on the right side. Abraham dances almost to midfield. Fidji and Slay with great blocking. Steve Thomas on the tackle.
Gerald Abraham's been quiet, but lest we forget, over 1,200 yards this year. Wyoming not going to move him out, but those little draw plays will work. You get the defensive line rushing the passer. Now Iowa's in this game. They're going to get a lot more aggressive defensively, and they'll be susceptible to traps and draws and maybe screens because they'll be coming after Burnett.
Abraham, 12 carries, 35 yards rushing now, the senior out of Denver. First down for the Pokes. 14:23 left. And the storyline from San Diego in the Holiday Bowl. Iowa, two defensive touchdowns. One off a blocked punt, the other off the interception. Iowa, two drives that failed inside the three. One a fumble just about at the two-inch line. Otherwise, it was six. That's a big turnover. Hawkeyes would have the lead, 21-19. But they trail by five. Shoulda, coulda, woulda. Nothing doing that time. Abraham in the grasp of J.J. Puck. Two brothers played for the Gophers at Minnesota. And, of course, J.J. Puck had that big interception in last year's Holiday Bowl. The senior out of Cedar Rapids, Iowa.
Well, you can feel the intensity for the Hawkeyes all the way up here in the booth. Certainly at the linebacker position, that was instant recognition. I was watching them all the way, and bang, they came up. Now, Wyoming would like to run the ball here. The time problem, they'd like to run some time off the clock. They have the lead, but they may not be capable of doing it against Iowa.
Don't forget, coming up right after the Holiday Bowl, live, the NHL on ESPN, the Jets and the Kings. Mike Emmerich and Bill Clement standing by in L.A., red-eyed out of New York after last night's game. Safety valve, complete, first down and more, but forget it, this one's coming back. If it's against the Cowboys. Kilpatrick on the catch. Will it be holding or will it be roughing the passer? The way the Hawkeyes are protesting, I think it's against Iowa. Nope. They won the protest. An 18-yard reception will be nullified. You saw that shot.
Holding on the offense, 10 yards from the previous spot, still second down.
Saw that shot of Paul Roach over on the sideline, the 60-year-old coach of the Cowboys. Asked him at practice the other day, one of his kids went up to him and said, "Coach, I'd like to be a head coach like you someday." What advice he would give that young man? And he kind of chuckled and he said, "Don't wait until you're 59 to become a head coach."
As if he had any choice, Coach Roach here. You know, he probably should have been a head coach long ago. The Wyoming people evidently inquired when he was in Oakland. But Coach said that Al Davis said he wasn't interested but had forgotten to ask him.
Yeah, Kurt Gowdy said that he had discussed it with Al Davis, and Al said no, Paul wasn't interested in the job. Burnett fires to Scott Joseph, and Joseph up at the 45-yard line. Sean Ridley on the stop, the junior out of Omaha. Yeah, Paul said he really didn't have that burning desire to become a head coach. He had a very successful assistant career with John Madden in Oakland, with Bart Starr at Green Bay, with Red Miller in Denver. And he talked about the influence of John Madden and Red Miller. He said John Madden was the best pass designer he'd ever been around. Great ability to design pass schemes. And from Red Miller, he said he got a great feel at what it takes to win. 12-13 and counting. Abraham in motion. Dropped at the 39-yard line by Loving. Thrown behind him would have been a first down. So the Hawkeyes will get the ball.
Here's Burt. If this ball isn't thrown wide behind him, there's no way that he doesn't intercept this pass. Now watch Loving. If that ball's thrown right to Loving, Burt's got the interception.
Tom Kilpatrick out of Sheridan, Wyoming, is back to do the punting. Peter Marciano at the 14, backpedals, looks for a blocker and goes nowhere. Good coverage by the Cowboys specialty teams with 11:53 left to go. Cowboys lead is 5.
How does the bottle work again?
Well, I fill it with authentic Guinness Draught.
Yes.
So we can walk outside.
Yes.
Go down to the Glen.
Yes.
And drink it.
Drink beer at a picnic. Brilliant. What will you think of next?
You know the way you call your mum?
Yes.
Well, I've created a device that lets you talk to her.
Brilliant.
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 Guinness Draught, straight from the bottle. Enjoy it everywhere.
Brilliant.
Sunday nights on ESPN Classic.
We got any quitters here?
No, sir!
As if the action on the field weren't dramatic enough, Hollywood and Classic take your favorite sports from field to film on Real Classics.
Let's play some football!
The stars.
In my book, we're going to be winners.
The stories.
Wax on, wax off.
The drama.
I'd do anything for you, but don't ask me to play a clown!
Real Classics, where the worlds of sports and movies collide. 8 p.m. Sundays only on ESPN Classic.
No way.
Introducing the Del Delf Holiday Sweepstakes.
You're the Delf, Delf, right?
Yes, I am.
Yes, I knew it. I knew
Go
it.
Go online now to see how you could win over $60,000 in prizes.
Who's the big winner?
Sir?
You can just pull it in the driveway.
Did you tell me where the Ziegelman's house is?
It's right there.
Thanks.
Wait.
It's a Del. Every week, one lucky winner gets the Dell Toy Box, a Cadillac Escalade filled with a 700M wireless notebook powered by Intel Centrino Mobile Technology, an awesome Dell 42-inch plasma TV, the new Pocket DJ, this new Dell photo printer, and a $500 gift card plus much more. And there's a new winner every week. Go online now to see how you could win and get great deals on this Dimension desktop with the power and performance of an Intel Pentium 4 processor. It's only $539 with a free flat panel upgrade. Plus, get free two-day shipping. Get more out of ordering a Dell this holiday, and get more out of now. Dell PCs use Intel Pentium 4 processors.
Along with Charlene Hawks and Kevin Kiley, I'm Jim Kelly. There's our time left, 11:53 and a 5-point Wyoming lead. Hawkeyes of Iowa start from their own 13-yard line. Little slant behind Anderson, Divis, and Webster goes David Hudson, senior out of Texas, 6'2", 235, in the grasp of Jeff Napton.
I'm starting to move them out in the middle there, Jim. Those stunts, they're not looking like stunts anymore. They're starting to push these guys back on the Wyoming defensive line.
A touchdown would do it for Iowa, or two field goals. And certainly 11 and a half to go, lots of time for either. Book on Hartley tonight. A slow developing play, didn't look like much, but it went for good yardage. And it went all the way up to the 28-yard line. Rick Bayless out of Hugo, Minnesota, his first carry tonight, the senior.
Bayless was their leading rusher last year, had a great year, but he's been injured. He had a knee on against Iowa State. He hasn't played hardly at all year, but he's a great athlete and really wanted to play in this game. There was some concern about whether he'd be 100%, but he's out there, and that was a tremendous cutback he made on that play.
Had a shoulder injury against Minnesota, too. There goes Bayless again, second straight carry, and you can see the delicate balance. He hammers up to the 33-yard line. Shy of first down yardage, of course, and Scott Hanser, who was also bothered by injuries, and we were told Hanser would not start just before the game. A good addition for the Cowboys.
He was injured yesterday, number 44 in your screen, a freak injury on his ankle in practice. They said there was no chance he'd start, but early in the, just before the game, Wyoming people came up to me and told me he would start. So they must have strapped his ankle up pretty well.
Second and six from the 32. 10:15 left to go. Hartlib on a rope, goes for all of it. It's caught at the 20, to the 18, to the 17. Travis Rutkin. A 48-yard reception. Watch the concentration. The sophomore from Claremont, California, number two.
A little rollout to get away from the rush, and then a perfect pass by Hartlib over the defense to Rutkin.
Pretty cool cat, that Chuck Hartley. Doesn't get too excited.
Probably the difference in their offense in the second half, certainly in that play, has been the protection and that little roll they let him take.
A little reverse pivot, and David Hudson hammers behind Schmidt and Anderson and Schenbeck. Mike Schenbeck, who's had a terrific game for Wyoming, helped out by Jeff Knapp. There is Schenbeck, number 55, out of Aurora, Colorado. He plans to attend law school. Been all over the field for the Cowboys.
This is a gut check now. It's nose to nose. Iowa's strength, physical advantage against Wyoming, and a bunch of tired blitzers and stunners back there. And the Cowboys going to win this. They're going to have to do it right now.
9:20 and counting left to go. Hudson and Goodman are the running backs. Early harbors the wide receiver. Hartley backpedals, fires to the 15. He's got Marv Cook, the tight end. Hanser hammers him out of bounds. Clock is stopped. 9:06 left to go. Cowboys led 12-0. Hawkeyes got their first 7 points on a blocked punt. But then the Wyoming Cowboys came right back, and they led 19-7 at halftime. Third quarter was scoreless for both teams. And then the Hawkeyes, on a 32-yard interception by Anthony Wright, closed to within 5, 19-14. That's where we are right now. And the Hawkeyes have used one of their 3 timeouts. They're down to 2. Cowboys have all 3 left. Third and 2, spotted at the 12-yard line. Double tight ends, Cook and Clark. Bayless in at running back. This is Richard Bass, number 23. First down and more. Thaxton on the stop, but not before Bass cracks it inside the 5. First and goal for the Hawkeyes. The yellow and black coming up.
This is a great call. Now watch Bass. He's the outside guy, 23. It's a counter like the old scissor. They use the eye for misdirection, and they use that aggressiveness of the Wyoming defense against them. And there's the aggressiveness right there. 5, 6, 7 guys, but a great call. Bass on a little counter. Wyoming over pursuing, getting caught.
Obviously, watch the tight ends. Cook, 84, Clark, 49, and Mike Flagg, 86.
I'm looking for a run here, Jim. I'm going to pound him.
Motion from the left side. Dave Alexander,
You can't miss him.
That might change. No, you can't. 6'3", 270.
Dead ball. Illegal procedure on the offense. Still first down.
That was a big penalty now because almost certainly Iowa was going to run the ball. In fact, I'll tell you what they were going to do. They were going to run it left because Alexander, when he went offsides, he was trying to hook the defensive end or tackle. So that meant that they were coming left. Let's see if they keep the same play in.
Well, they were going to run behind Dave Alexander, the man who jumped off. There he is. He started the season at right guard but moved over to left tackle to replace Kratch, who was injured. 6'3", 270, so... Those offensive linemen, they've got to know all the blocking schemes. There he is.
It's Alexander. And look at him turning his body, trying to hook the defensive player. Now, that would indicate to me they were going that way, but now they have 10 yards to go and not five, and it may change their philosophy just a little bit.
Motion by Goodman. Back to Bayless. Bayless dances, stutter steps, and gets the five of the penalty back. Second and goal from just outside the five coming back as Darryl Slick Harris made the stop. And the man that taught them how to win took over after 19 straight losing seasons behind four coaches. Hayden Fry has the glasses off. He said, you just don't win. You've got to know and learn how to win. The game is 90% mental. And he likes to relate to successful people as he talks to his troops during the week. In fact, sometimes during the week, he'll have his players get up in front of the whole team, and they'll have to talk about being successful and what it takes and the dedication. Hudson, Bass, and Bayless are in. Close to the goal line goes David Hudson. Third and less than the length of the football coming up for an Iowa touchdown. They've been behind the entire game.
I want you to watch the heads of the Wyoming defense. If you can see them when they come by and see how high they are. See the Wyoming hats, how high they are. That means you're getting tired. If the black hats get lower than the white hats, it means that they just can't get near Crouch anymore. And that's what happens to a defensive player when he gets exhausted. The Iowa people are just pounding it in now. And there's that Big Ten advantage, that bigger, more physical team taking over.
That far to go for the lead. Touchdown, Iowa. David Hudson. Yeah, now do you think about the two-point conversion? It's 2019. 1 point only gives you a two-point lead. So I think Hayden Fry has to go for the two-point conversion and a three-point.
1 point does absolutely no good for you. Touchdown again. It's a quick snap. Wyoming not ready. See how they're trying to bury down there, and then there's just nobody there. Looked like Wyoming got off the ball just too quick. Hudson waited for the ball to go by and stepped into the end zone. I remember Wyoming. Wyoming is one of these teams that comes back and comes back.
Here comes the 2-point try. Hartlieb at quarterback. Early, wide, bottom of your screen. Play action fake. Hartlieb will throw. Incomplete at the 2 and almost picked off by Scott Hanser. So some grimaces on the face of Hayden Fry. We'll take time out. It's a 1-point lead.
No enemy has ever withstood our might. I need a weapon.
Rated M for mature.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light.
This holiday season, put out the good stuff. Planters.
This holiday, discover the magic at Radio Shack. And during our big two-day sale, Tuesday and Wednesday only, get great deals on very entertaining gifts. Like this DVD player, just $34.99 after rebate. A 7-inch portable DVD player, only $129.99 after rebate. And a 15-inch Magnavox LCD TV, only $399.99 after rebates. Tuesday and Wednesday, right in your neighborhood.
Only at Radio Shack.
Honey, does this make me look fat?
You betcha.
In the time it takes to pull out the sleeper sofa, you could save hundreds on car insurance. Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
Can your glue do this or this? Wonder Glue can, but it won't save you any money on car insurance.
Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
Why haven't you called Geico?
One ordinary cop.
I did not murder him!
I'm sorry, I'm allergic to bullets.
One extraordinary adventure.
Somehow, I told you so, doesn't quite say it.
I, Robot, tomorrow.
Gotcha.
For the past 2 years, my mom has been the team mom.
Yes.
She likes to knit. A lot. She watches very closely what we eat.
Boys, what is this?
And of course, she makes sure we eat our Campbell's chunky soup, like new savory beef pot roast.
How about those big chunks of beef and veggies?
Our team's a family, and she's the mom.
Campbell's chunky. It fills you up right.
He's a king just like Elvis.
A look back at a racing legend.
When I had my neck broke, I shouldn't have been driving. I've driven with broke ribs. I've driven with broke feet.
Meet Richard Petty, the king of NASCAR. 60 Minutes on Classic, 8 p.m. Tuesday on ESPN Classic.
There's our score, 20-19. The first time the Hawkeyes have led all night. They trailed 12-0. We've got 7:33 left to go. And, of course, we've been talking to you about the fact that the Holiday Bowl has a history of very, very close finishes. Four of the nine previous Holiday Bowls, Kevin, have been decided by a single point. In 79, Indiana by one against BYU. In 80, BYU by one against SMU. In 85, Arkansas beat Arizona State by a point. And in 86, the Hawkeyes on that last second field goal beat San Diego State by just one.
Well, we could have another one here, Jim, if Wyoming kicked a field goal.
I thought your lips were frozen.
Yeah. Well, I was trying to count. Now, that would be by two, wouldn't it? Well, never mind.
You mean if the Cowboys kicked a field
goal?
Yeah. But if it stays like this, it's decided by one.
You're right.
High, but not very deep. Steve Bannon at the 12. Good return across the 30 near the 32. Well, we've talked about some of the comeback wins. Arizona against Iowa. They trailed. Hawkeyes came back to win by a point. Hawkeyes were trailing Indiana. Came back and won by 8. They were trailing Northwestern by 10. No contest. And against the Buckeyes, they were down by 5. They won by 2. So the Hawkeyes know how to come back. They have done it here tonight. We'll find out now if the Cowboys know how to come back. Craig Burnett, senior quarterback. Quick out, good read. Fires to James Loving. Loving running laterally east-west instead of north-south. A lot of running for a pickup of 1. Second and 9, and a good defensive play by the sophomore right cornerback, Dallas, Texas, number 45. Here he comes, Merton Hanks. Where is it?
Here's your receiver. Watch what they do here. When you get the back in motion right here, he's going to head out here. The defensive man who circled is going to go out on him and going to hit the receiver, this receiver right there immediately. See how he clears out there? Burnett hits the receiver. That's Loving, and he takes off with the ball.
Second and 7. The ball at the 34, 6:52 and counting. Delay to Abraham. Approaches the 40-yard line. J.J. Puck has him there.
If Wyoming is to use all of the time and kick a field goal, they're going to have to run the ball. Up. They cannot just pass exclusively.
Have to start thinking about the seniors on both sides, but especially the seniors of that man, Paul Roach. They've been through a lot of turmoil, different coaches, transition. Now they're looking for some continuity. They need 3 to keep the football. Incomplete at the 44-yard line. Benna out of the backfield. Burnett had to throw sooner than he wanted to because number 5, Mike Burke, the senior out of Davenport, Iowa. 9 tackles this year against Minnesota. He was looking for a sack.
Boy, this thing's wide open, too. Benna with a little block, and then he's going to slip top right of your screen. If that ball is complete, he's got nothing but green going down the field.
And had David Haight picked it off, this game would have been history. 6:09 left. Peter Marciano is back deep. And Tom Kilpatrick will kick it away. The junior out of Sheridan, Wyoming. He's had four punts, averaging 33 yards a night. This is a beautiful spiral. It backs Marciano up all the way to the 13-yard line. Marciano almost decapitated at the 15, is sliced down at the 17. Well, down on the sidelines are Charlene Hawks.
There are 22 seniors here on this Wyoming team. These seniors have been through three coaches in 4 years. They haven't had continuity until this year when Paul Roach brought it for them, and they want to continue on with it. This is a big moment for them these last few minutes. They want to come from behind and win it like they have all season long. Jim?
Well, Charlene, what Paul told you and Kevin and I at practice the other day, he was really happy for the entire squad, but especially happy for this bunch of seniors because of all they've been through. To have a winning season, to win the WAC championship, and to be here at the Holiday Bowl. Breaking a tackle, and look out, up to the 25, up to the 29 goes David Hudson. Now the Cowboys, Kevin, are wearing down. They had him stopped for a 2-yard loss. Instead, it's an 8-yard pickup.
You're right, Jim, what you just said. Napton there just got crushed. He got literally buried. There was nobody outside, and that's why Iowa could come around here left. They're just tired. They are tired.
In fact, it might be close enough to measure.
That's part of a game plan, too. You know, a team like Iowa that is physically strong will try to wear you down. They don't get upset when they get behind early because they know they'll come on a little later.
That was just a great individual effort by David Hudson. Six-two, 235 pounds, 103 carries coming in, 5 touchdowns, a 4.1 rushing yardage average. But boy, that was a great run for a first down. 10 tough ones, and gives the Hawkeyes a little bit more breathing room. Clock a factor now, 5:35 and counting. And as the Hawkeyes discuss the situation, we'll remind you we've got the National Hockey League coming up, the Winnipeg Jets and the LA Kings right after our Holiday Bowl. Mike Emmerich and Bill Clement standing by out in Los Angeles, California. Actually, it's about what, a 2-hour drive up the road. You want to go up to the game?
I'm getting in my car right afterwards. I want to catch the last quarter. Oh, period. I'm sorry. That's what's happening. Maybe it'll go to overtime. We can make it.
To a game the other night. I saw the Red Wings and the North Stars. Sat behind the Red Wing bench. Jacques Demers has done a great job with the Wings. Rick Bayless. Hole opened up on the right side by Herb Webster and Greg Dibas. And Bayless out of Hugo, Minnesota, picks up some big yardage. Again, that offensive line of the Hawkeyes taking control.
As you watch on television, watch the helmets. And you'll see that the white helmets are a lot higher than the black helmets. And that means that your defense is tired. And I said it earlier, but it's getting more and more apparent. When your legs go, they straighten out and you get taller. And when your tall football players are not in demand.
Watkins left, early right. Wouldn't expect Hartley to throw it. They'll keep it on the ground, and this is Bayless. You can hear the collision up here. Schenbeck has played a whale of a game.
He stayed home right in his area, and he was waiting for that play. As you said, good play by Schenbeck, who's played extremely well all day. There's a big down coming up here.
5:21, 5:20 and counting. Hawkeyes have 2 timeouts left. Cowboys with all 3, but they need the football back. 3rd and 3. They've got to stuff Iowa here. Give their offense time. They're down by 1. Hudson and Goodman in the backfield. Sideline incomplete. How about the play call? Do you like it? 3rd and 3.
I was trying to think what they would do, and I really had no idea based on their ability to run here late in the game. I didn't know whether they would run or pass. In retrospect, obviously it didn't work, but Wyoming got real good pressure on Hartley.
Pressure by Raybould and by Thaxton.
Now, early in the game, Wyoming was very close to blocking a punt of Iowa. They seemed they gave up on it later on.
Back to punt. Marv Cook hangs it high. It's a spiral, and it's at the 17 for Anthony Sargent. Sargent to the 25-yard line. 3:44 left to go. The Cowpokes with all three timeouts left. All they need is a field goal. They trail by one.
The best superhero movie ever is the Ultimate Special Edition DVD.
Hang on!
Two discs loaded with over 10 hours of all new content.
Go get him, Tiger.
Spider-Man 2, now on DVD.
So what's this about our Guinness again?
I've discovered the Guinness draft has only 125 calories.
Only 125 calories? Brilliant! What else have you been up to?
I've invented this little book. It's black. You put women's phone numbers in it.
A little black book? Brilliant!
Come here often.
You can also use it as a coaster.
A coaster? Brilliant!
Brilliant!
Guinness draft has only 125 calories. Enjoy it responsibly.
Brilliant!
We thought they'd never find us. We were wrong.
No enemy has ever withstood our might.
I need a weapon.
There are those who said this day would never come. What are they to say now?
Rated M for mature.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light.
So this holiday season, put out the good stuff. Planters.
Yeah, I'll call you from the car.
Mama has no about 10 years ago.
Dial Laura.
Technology to go. Chevy Trailblazer. An American Revolution.
Also the home of the America's Cup, which came home along with Stars and Stripes, US 55. A couple of the crew stopped by earlier tonight to say hello. .344 left to go. Off left tackle goes Sergeant Haight on the stop. There is Mr. Worker, who has two field goals and an extra point on the night. It could come down to his right toe. And there is the Holiday Bowl MVP trophy. It could belong to Greg Worker if he can pull this one out for the Cowpokes. 3:18 and counting left to go in this football game. Spot the ball at the 26-yard line. Second down and 9. Loving, 83, Sergeant 6. They're the wide receivers in the flood formation along with Eric Loftus, number 20. Motion by Gibson, top of your screen. Burnett, his 45th pass of the night to Gibson, and Gibson knifes his way up close to the 35-yard line where Dave Haight, the nose guard, made the tackle. Kevin, if you've got the nose guard catching the back out of the backfield, you know the secondary and the linebackers missed some assignments.
Well, also though, he hesitated. That pattern, it was no pattern. He just sat at the line of scrimmage and then came inside to Haight. These guys are dropping into coverage, Jim. When they drop back into zones, Haight just as free as the next guy. I'm wondering why he's not rushing the passer.
Play is sent in. Craig Burnett on throwing his 45th pass, attempting the Holiday Bowl record of 48 set by Jim McMahon for BYU back in 1980 as they took on SMU. Third and a yard. Burnett fires. He's got the first down at the 40-yard line. And that's Gordy Wood, the freshman tight end. Kerry Burt with a collision.
Boy, you got to really love the poise of both of these teams. Iowa coming from behind, Wyoming trying to come from behind, and Burnett standing there and firing darts right on the money. Third and down, and they knew, third and short, and they knew they couldn't run the ball. They gave up on the run there.
Nail-biting time for Hayden Fry and for Paul Roach. The game hangs in the balance. 1:57 left. Cowboys with still three timeouts. Burnett fires, got his man at the 46-yard line. The Sarge again. Anthony Sargent out of L.A. Puck and Quast were back there. Great concentration by Burnett and Sargent. Boy, you get the idea that these guys have practiced together. They're just on the same page.
Well, they say these guys are fearless, Jim, and they say the little wide receivers are fearless. I think the same is true of the quarterback, Burnett. And they've worked together, and they've made it work all year. 8-0 in the WAC.
First and 10 from the 45 of the Iowa Hawkeye. Burnett fires wide open at the 40. At the 35, Scott Joseph, the senior out of Oakland, California, another junior college transfer picked up by Paul Roach. He believes in J.C. transfers. Kerry Burt back there on the coverage. 47 passes, one more, and Burnett will tie the Holiday Bowl record. But he's not thinking about that record. He's thinking about winning the Holiday Bowl.
Well, you'll definitely see one more. No question.
You're going to see a bunch more. We've got 81 seconds left to go. Cowboys have all three timeouts.
The loss of Hoffman, I think, is going to hurt the Cowboys when they get in close if they want to go for the end zone. The tight end went out with a broken arm earlier in this game.
What a Cinderella story it would be for Paul Roach, who took over the Cowboys at the age of 59. In October, celebrated his 60th birthday. The only older head coach in NCAA is Joe Paterno at Penn State.
That was number 16 that just came out was Kilpatrick. Now, he was the backup tight end. They're taking him out of the game, and they're going to go with wide receivers.
Gordy Wood, the freshman tight end, number 95, is in. First and 10 at the 35-yard line. Play-action fake by Craig Burnett. Fires over the middle, misfires at the 18-yard line. A little high for Eric Loftus, and he knows it. He was open. When you fire high, it's just like a baseball pitcher. You've released a little too soon.
Well, the one pass that he threw high down here at the other end is the one that gave Iowa their second touchdown. You don't want to throw it high, not against the zone.
Second and 10, 64 seconds left in the Holiday Bowl.
They need about 10 or 12 yards for a legitimate attempt at a field goal.
Gibson motions far side. Burnett on the post. Incomplete at the 7, intended for Sargent. Interesting, because they kind of nickel-dime their way down the field. Now you get it down to the 35-yard line, Kevin, and now you're going up top and you're going a lot deeper.
It's an excellent observation, but it's what Iowa is giving them. They're giving them that deep middle, and they're trying to keep them from getting those short patterns. And you can't, you know, when you program a quarterback to read defenses, you can't unprogram. And this guy's reading, and that's what's open.
Line of scrimmage, the 35-yard line. They need 10 here on third down.
Sargent, a double cover Sargent. He's the guy who's made the big catches all year.
Not a bad time if you're the Hawkeyes to come with a blitz. They know the Cowboys are going to throw. They play it straight. Burnett fires, and it is caught and then dropped. It was almost intercepted. Loving had it. Then one of the Hawkeyes had it, and finally it fell down onto the ground. Brad Quast was back there, number 35, along with number 3, Kerry Burt. Here it comes.
The question I've got here is if it's interference or not. They're both going for the ball. That's no interference. They have a right to the ball. Now, Loving almost had it, and I know that's what he's thinking about right now.
So, we will have the field goal try by Greg Worker, his longest of the year, 51 yards against Hawaii. This will be a 52-yarder, hash mark far side. The Holiday Bowl hangs in the balance. Blocked! Merton Hanks. There he is, the sophomore out of Dallas. He's a high hurdles champion in the 110 meters. He couldn't have jumped any higher there. Watch number 45, the sophomore out of Dallas, 6'2". He stretches out. The good speed, the acceleration.
You call him lanky. He comes right from this area here, Jim. You called him lanky earlier. He'll come right across and block it right at that point.
Untouched. 46 seconds left to go, and Hayden Fry, who has his Hawkeyes in 7 straight bowl games, just has to run out the clock to win this one.
What are you holding now?
A six-pack.
A six-pack? Brilliant! What's it do?
Well, I figured out how to carry six beers at the same time.
Carry six beers at the same time? Brilliant! Let's drink them.
You know, I've been thinking, it might not be the smartest idea to drink six beers at the same time.
Don't drink six beers at the same time? Brilliant!
Brilliant!
Drink Guinness Draught straight from the bottle and always enjoy it responsibly.
Brilliant!
On the joyous days of bowl week, my TV gives to me. Tailbacks are sweeping, quarterbacks are throwing, wrestles are lolling, head coach is screaming.
Capital One Bowl Week, December 27th through January 1st on ESPN and ESPN2.
He's a king just like Elvis.
A look back at a racing legend.
When I had my neck broke, I shouldn't have been driving. I've driven with broke ribs. I've driven with broke feet.
Meet Richard Petty, the king of NASCAR. 60 Minutes on Classic, 8 p.m. Tuesday on ESPN.
What's under the hood of today's cars? State-of-the-art engines, sophisticated computer technology, drivetrains, electrical systems, hydraulics. Sound good? Then you're ready to live your passion and accelerate your future at Universal Technical Institute. At UTI campuses across the country, you'll get the training you need to launch your career as an automotive or diesel technician. Training that's customized to fit your learning style. And get this, financial aid is available for those who qualify. Our strategic relationships with leading manufacturers means training on all the cars you dream about. Cars like Ford, Audi, Porsche, Volvo, Toyota, Jaguar, Mercedes-Benz, BMW, International, Volkswagen. These manufacturers all come to UTI for skilled technicians. But here's the best part. The demand for trained technicians is huge and will be for years to come. Call UTI today. Live your passion. Accelerate your future. Universal Technical Institute.
That 52-yard field goal try was blocked. But if you're a Wyoming rooter, 46 seconds left to go, three timeouts. If they can stop the Hawkeyes, and if the defense stiffens here, they might get the football back again. Hudson hammers up near the 25. Cowboys quickly take a timeout. Talk a little bit, Kevin, about what we were talking with Paul Roach about the other day, the importance of this game, being on national television, playing well against a Big Ten team, how it would affect his program in terms of recruiting.
I think he's accomplished that. They'd like to win the game. If the score holds up a one-point loss, I think that Wyoming has proven that they can play with the second team in the Big Ten. Of course, Iowa and Indiana tied for second behind Michigan State. Iowa is one of the great programs in the country. Wyoming doesn't get the opportunity to be on TV much, and I hope people appreciate what kind of an effort this is from these kids to play nose-to-nose with Iowa. And in fact, their defense has held Iowa to one touchdown in this game, which is a remarkable effort.
Well, while you go home and celebrate New Year's Day, some of us will be working. I'll be in the Cotton Bowl in Dallas, Notre Dame, taking on Texas A&M. It all starts at 11:30 a.m. Eastern time on New Year's Day. College football game day. What a great game day we've got for you. Reports from all the bowl games. And what a great effort there. Rick Bayless is stifled. Donahue. Another timeout. 34 seconds left to go. Cowboys have one. And you certainly wouldn't expect Iowa to put the ball up here.
No.
So I think that Wyoming definitely will get the ball back.
Well, and as I said earlier, the first two punts that Iowa attempted were very nearly blocked. And I would expect Wyoming to send everybody.
34 seconds left to go. Wyoming will get the ball back when we come back.
This holiday, discover the magic at Radio Shack. And during our big two-day sale, Tuesday and Wednesday only, get great deals on very entertaining gifts. Like this DVD player, just $34.99 after rebate. A 7-inch portable DVD player, only $129.99 after rebate. And a 15-inch Magnavox LCD TV, only $399.99 after rebates. Tuesday and Wednesday, right in your neighborhood.
Only at Radio Shack.
Inside that robot is something familiar, a battery. And while you may think all batteries are the same, listen to this. It's just the rain, but with his Phonak hearing aid, he's hearing it for the first time. And when Phonak chooses a battery, they trust Duracell.
You heard the rain.
So whether it's a child's hearing or child's play, it just has to work. Duracell, trusted everywhere.
A murder only he can solve. An enemy only he can defeat.
Hell no.
just shoot at me with your eyes closed?
It worked, didn't it?
Will Smith, I, Robot, tomorrow.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light.
So this holiday season, put out the good stuff. Planters.
So what's this about our Guinness again?
I've discovered that Guinness Draft has only 125 calories.
Only 125 calories? Brilliant! What else have you been up to?
I've invented this little book. It's black. You put women's phone numbers in it.
A little black book? Brilliant!
Come here often.
You can also use it as a coaster.
A coaster? Brilliant!
Brilliant!
Guinness Draft has only 125 calories. Enjoy it responsibly.
Brilliant!
No enemy has ever withstood our might.
I need a weapon.
Rated M for mature.
Sunday nights.
We got any quitters here?
No, I'm not!
The stars. The stories.
Wax on. Wax off.
The drama. Real classics, where the worlds of sports and movies collide. 8 p.m. Sundays only on ESPN Classic.
Along with Charlene Hawks and Kevin Kiley, I'm Jim Kelly. Iowa leads by a point with 34 seconds left to go, but the Hawkeyes looking at third and 10 from their own 20. Trap, misdirection, does nothing. Cowboys converge. They quickly call timeout. 29 seconds left to go. They're out of timeouts. They'll get the ball back, and they'll try to get it back into field goal range for another shot for Greg Werker. Now, do you send everybody and try to block this punt?
Well, you have, well, because of the field goal, you have to keep one guy back so the ball doesn't bounce and you lose 30 yards. If he has to kick it quick, they could very possibly get the ball back around midfield. But, yeah, I send everybody on this one.
They've got Sargent back deep at the 40-yard line. He's got explosive speed.
Well, fair catch, it's timeout. So you figure he's going to fair catch it. The Iowa people are not going to cover it that well because they have to make sure that they block the Wyoming defensive line. So this game is not over. And we're talking Craig Burnett and the Wyoming team are averaging 400-plus yards a game. They should get the ball with right around 20 to 25 seconds left in the game, enough for one, two, or three plays and a field goal attempt.
I would bet you if Sarge sees a little open yardage, he's going to make a catch and try to get the ball back at least midfield or beyond. Here they come. High, high hanging kick. Sargent calls for the fair catch at the 40-yard line. 23 seconds left to go. Four of the first nine Holiday Bowls have been decided by a point. Will this be five of the first 10? Hawkeyes lead Wyoming by just one. No timeouts left for Wyoming.
Well, they have to go wide or get big yardage. So if you're playing defense, you're thinking they're going to go wide, short, or they're going to go deep down the middle. A short pass down the middle is something you're going to give them because you can surround them and it'll use time. And it makes it a little easier to play defense, but you get nervous. So you don't want to be the one that gets the bomb thrown on him either.
They have a flood formation wide to the left. James Loving, 83, Anthony Sargent, 6, and Eric Loftus, number 20. Burnett's 51st pass on the night. Penalty flag is down. Ball is caught. 40, 35, 33-yard line goes James Loving. But a flag is down at the 38-yard line.
Boy, that's a tough call. To make that call at this point in the game, that's a tough call. If that's a holding call, that's a tough one.
A 26-yard pickup negated by a holding call against Wyoming.
And more importantly, 9 seconds it took for that play.
Cowboys have no timeouts left, 26 huge yards, and now 10 more the other way. They would have had the ball down at about the 33-yard line.
The offense, 10 yards from the previous spot, still first down.
And, Kevin, if they had the ball at the 33, 14 seconds, you run a quick out, maybe try to pick up 5-8 yards, and Greg Worker's definitely in field goal.
Well, they were 2 yards closer than they were on the last attempt on that play, so they would have had, you're right, time to either try the field goal or get a little bit closer. Now they're in big trouble because without a timeout now, it's conceivable.
Yeah, they may not get another playoff.
Well, now they've got the I don't understand that.
Now they start the clock.
Yeah, Wyoming needed to be at the line of scrimmage and they were in the huddle. It's the last play of the game.
intercepted at the 48-yard line by Merton Hanks, who blocked the last field goal try attempted by Wyoming. The thrifty car rental players of the game for Iowa, Anthony Wright. He had the 32-yard interception that got the Hawkeyes back in it. And Craig Burnett, who set a new Holiday passing bowl record with 53 attempts tonight. The thrifty car rental players of the game. The Holiday Bowl, with a history of fantastic finishes, we've had another one here tonight. Five of the first 10 Holiday Bowls decided by 1 point. The Hawkeyes by one against the Cowboys. Congratulations to Hayden Fry in Iowa and also to Paul Roach in Wyoming. For Kevin Kiley, I'm Jim Kelly. Hockey is next. Good night, everybody.